Hi people, welcome back. This is Neha and today we are going to practice a very simple asana which can be done by anyone and everyone and which has a lot of benefits out of it, okay, which is Vajrasana. So before that, I want you to subscribe my channel and click a bell icon next to it so that you'll be notified with my upcoming videos. Alright, so Vajrasana is one of the very simple asanas which you can practice anywhere. Preferably it is done after food because it is amazingly good on your digestive system. And this is the only asana which is allowed immediately after food. So in yoga we always say, like, you know, if you have like your stomach full, if you just have your meals, you're not supposed to practice yoga. But then this is one of the postures which will help you a lot to get a better digestion system. And if you have any gastric, any issues like that, this asana can be really wonder on you. Okay, so let's see how to practice that. As I told you, it's quite simple. So you just have to stand on your knee by your both the toes facing out. Okay, so here one thing that I would want to tell you, to keep your toe on each other. Okay, so you're going to keep your both the toe on each other, but it depends which toe you're going to keep on which toe. So for example, you can just like check your nostril right now. Just like close your eyes and just observe your nostril. So you can figure out that only one nostril is active. Either you're breathing from the right or you're breathing from the left. So most of the times our nostril pattern is like we are breathing through one nostril, okay? So right now, if you're breathing from your right nostril, then you keep your right toe on another. If you're breathing from the left nostril, you're gonna keep the left toe on top. So that's how you're gonna decide. So right now, so my breathing pattern is I'm breathing from the right. So I'll keep my right toe on the left. So depending on your breathing pattern, you can keep your toe on each other. So once you keep your toe on each other, your heels are slightly apart and you're going to place your hip on your heel very comfortably. So here you keep your knee together, spine slightly arched, not like completely open up with your chest. You're being very comfortable where you can keep your shoulders relaxed. If you keep your spine too straight, it might be like you're congesting yourself, you're forcing yourself. As this asana is going to be very relaxed on you, so try to keep it like slightly relaxed. Drop your shoulders completely down and drop your hands, your arms, the entire hands weight on your thigh. So this is how the posture is going to look like. You're going to keep your head in center, spine relaxed, your hip is completely relaxed on your toe. And your neck, your shoulder is completely relaxed again. Very simple, right? So a lot of times what happens, you're not very comfortable with this posture. Either your thighs are too tight, you can feel a lot of stretch. So at that time, you can keep your knees slightly apart. You can keep your thighs slightly apart, because of which the posture will become slightly easy for you. And say like your ankles are too tight and your feet is really hurting right now. If you're not used to it, it might happen to you. So you don't have to worry. So what you can do is slowly lift your hip up, take your toes out, get your both the legs forward, sit in this posture, keeping your both the legs straight, shake your both the feet like as fast as possible. When you do this, automatically your pain will start getting disappeared. Okay, then you can relax. If you want, you can again try Vajrasana after this. As I told you, this practice can be done anytime, especially after food and before food. If you can practice for 5 minutes, it's going to be great. And elderly people, if they have like a knee pain or something, they can keep a cushion or they can keep a pillow below the hip and then they can do it. So maybe you can just keep a pillow, you can sit on it. It will be easy for you to practice. Okay, so have a better digestion system. Keep your abdominal muscles toned through this asana and eat healthy and stay healthy. Thank you.